I will never understand how Christians can convince themselves of their own moral superiority or even their own morality. Right? Like, theirs is a system where you can become absolved of all sin by silently apologizing to yourself. Or, if we want to be more generous, by apologizing to a mythical character that, by definition, is obligated to accept your apology and love you no less for your transgression. Jesus doesn't even demand that you rectify the problem or even that you apologize to whomever you might have slighted with your sinfulness. He asks only that you confess of your sin, at which point he's duty-bound to fully absolve you. That's the whole point. What's more, he doesn't even expect you to stop sinning afterwards. He knows fully well that you're going to fall short again, and when you do, he'll be ready to forgive that transgression as well. Jesus comes with infinite get-out-of-jail-free cards, and if you think that you can do moral philosophy that bad for 2,000 years without getting really shitty morality, I'd ask you to simply look at any Christian institution that has existed for any time period, anywhere, ever. All right, let's start with the oldest, the Catholic Church. Yes, they raped a bunch of kids, but they said they were sorry, right? They're going to make an earnest effort to do better in the future, but hey, they're flawed descendants of Eve living in a fallen world after all, so they're not going to do perfect, and Jesus stands ready to forgive them the next time they do it too. And since theirs is a forgiveness-based morality, there's no need for recompense. Right? There's no point in releasing the suspected pedophiles that they're still harboring in their quasi-state of child rapistan. Right? There's no reason to release the victims from the non-disclosure agreements that their financial compensation was contingent on. There's no reason to proactively give up the names of every little suspected pedophile to law enforcement. As long as everybody's admitted to their sins and sincerely apologized to Jesus, they're in the clear from an ethical perspective. In fact, all these minor reforms and reporting requirements and shit, that's just altruism icing on the said sorry can't get mad cake, if you think about it. Or how about we look at the second biggest denomination in the U.S., the Southern Baptist Convention. What is Southern Baptism anyway? Does the water spin the other way when you drain the baptismal font or something? No, it's fucking slavery. Right? Like, in the lead up to the Civil War, the Baptists in the South decided that they couldn't be friends with those abolitionist assholes in the North anymore, so they split off and made their very own baptism with hookers and slavery. Not only did the fucking Southern Baptists come into existence to provide theological justification for slavery and white supremacy, but that's also what they continued to do for at least a century after the Civil War. One could argue that's still what it does, but at the very fucking least, that's what it was doing into the 60s, providing theological justification for white supremacy. A couple years ago, the Southern Baptist Seminary, the oldest seminary affiliated with the SBC, tried to confront their racist origins with a report called The Report on Slavery and Racism in the History of the Southern Baptist Theological Seminary. And to their credit, it more or less did lay out their bigoted origins and their central role in justifying slavery, segregation, and white supremacy. More or less. They released this report in 2018, and they said they were super sorry, right? They did a whole thing on a stage where they had a black guy come on and accept her apology on behalf of African Americans. And that was that, morally cleansed by Christian standards. Of course, it's not like this legacy we're talking about is like thousands of years ago. They are still directly benefiting from this today. Like, for example, with their $100 million endowment almost universally donated to further the goal of maintaining the racist status quo. So a nearby historically black college said, hey, if you guys are really sorry, right, how about you tithe 10% of that racism fortune that you still have to us or to some other method of black empowerment? And the Southern Baptist Seminary was like, fuck you. We already said we were sorry. And that was that, right? Did you not hear the guy who accepted our apology? Like, despite Christian claims to the contrary, universal forgiveness is not a fucking virtue, and pretending otherwise is a vice. It's a bullshit bit of blame jujitsu. Yes, I'm the one who did something wrong, but I said I was sorry, which is good. You didn't accept my apology, which is bad. Therefore, we're both bad in this story, and you were bad last. In fact, this philosophy doesn't even require that I give you back your money as long as I've apologized to you for stealing it. So even temporarily withholding acceptance of my apology to see if anything's going to change is bad, or at least fall short of the ideal good. You should forgive me universally like Jesus would, and if you don't, that's really a problem with your ethics and not mine. Be more Christian. Is it any fucking wonder that people spoon-fed that shit their whole lives think that African-Americans are being greedy when they talk about reparations or affirmative action or any act whatsoever to help rectify the enormous imbalance of power that results from our nation's multi-century history of white supremacy? White people already said they were sorry, after all. Okay, Christianity is not a good source of morality. Hell, it isn't even a bad source of morality. It is a shortcut around morality, and it always has been. Incidentally, by the way, this diatribe is very much inspired by a book I'm reading called White Too Long, The Legacy of White Supremacy in American Christianity by Robert P. Jones. Normally, I would not recommend a book I'm not done with yet, but if this is a topic you want to explore more, at least the first half of this book is really fucking good. I'll link it in the show notes.